بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته My dear brothers and sisters in Islam from around the world We have Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen launched our crowdfunding campaign to build a masjid combined with a da'wah and tarbiyah center here in one of the most northern countries of the world, Norway. And brothers and sisters, we need your help. We need your help to support this campaign. We have Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen already from before launching the campaign raised approximately $1 million. So we're halfway there. But we need one more million to insha'Allah ta'ala establish this da'wah and tarbiyah center combined with a masjid. And why is this so important? Why should you actually care about this? I will tell you why. I will tell you why. Norway is a very unique country in terms of da'wah compared to other Western countries, especially if you compare it to the United Kingdom, America, or maybe even its neighboring countries such as Denmark or Sweden. Why is that? If you look at the da'wah in Denmark or Sweden, they have so many Islamic organizations and they have established many Islamic schools and kindergartens. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. If you look at UK, they have Allahu Akbar, Subhanallah Al-Azim. They have so many great Islamic organizations with so many full-time employed du'at, spreading the word of Allah, establishing the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they have so many Islamic schools and kindergartens. And subhanAllah al-Azim, you can see that the community of these Western countries, the Muslim communities of these Western countries, is flourishing. But when you compare that to Norway, in Norway we don't have a single Islamic school. We don't have a single Islamic da'wah and tarbiyah center. We don't have a single Islamic community center for the kids, for the shabab to come to, for the youth to come to. So how does that affect our community? Well, the Muslim youth is straying away from Islam. The vast majority of the Muslim youth, they do not pray. They do not pray. And the prayer, as you know, my dear brothers and beloved brothers and sisters, my dear beloved brothers and sisters, the prayer is the essential key for being a Muslim. So my dear brothers and sisters, the community of Norway is in a desperate need to save the Iman of our young brothers and sisters. And there is not a single da'wah organization dedicated to spread the message of Islam, the light of Islam, to the Western society, to the non-Muslim community, except our organization IslamNet. And we need to take that next step and establish this da'wah and tarbiyah center combined with a masjid. We don't have any single masjid in this country where the first language is our native, our local, our language, Norwegian. These masajid, the vast majority of these mosques, alhamdulillah, they're doing a great job in terms of what they are supposed to be doing, mashallah, tabarakallah. But they do not connect so good with the youth. Why is that? Because the majority of their Islamic programs, their khutbahs, the lectures, they are in the mother tongue of their older generation. So the youth, they do not connect so much to that anymore. So we need to have a Norwegian masjid, a Norwegian da'wah center, so we can connect with our shabab. And we should feel sorrow, we should feel pain in our hearts when we see that our youth is straying away. And as you know, it is an obligation upon every society, every community, to establish a group of brothers and sisters who are calling to the way of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Qur'an, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنَهُونَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ Let there be arising among you a group of people inviting to what is good and enjoining what is right and forbidding what is wrong. And these are the ones who are successful. So brothers and sisters, as you know, it is an obligation upon us to have a group of people who is giving da'wah, inviting people to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we as a community, if you as a community fail to do that, then the whole of community will be in sin. And I'm telling you, brothers and sisters, the vast majority of Norwegian young Muslims are straying away from Islam. So we need a collective effort. We need all of us, we need the world to contribute now. We can't wait another 10 years to raise money, and then we establish this da'wah center. Brothers and sisters, we need to do something now. Why is that? Because when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he saw the people not accepting his message, how did he feel? How did he feel? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Kahf, verse number 6, to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ إِنْ لَمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ أَسَفًا. Then perhaps you would kill yourself over grief over them if they do not believe in this message out of sorrow. Subhanallah al-Azim. Brothers and sisters, please take a lesson from this. Look at how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam felt for his people, how much he loved them. He couldn't stand that his people would not accept the message of Allah to such an extent that he would perhaps kill himself out of sorrow. Subhanallah al-Azim. Have you ever felt like this? Have you ever felt a sorrow like this because of Allah or because of your love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your people? That you would feel so sad if the people do not accept the message of Islam, or that you would feel so sad if the shabab of your community, if the youth would stray away from the deen. Brothers and sisters, this is how we should be feeling. This is exactly how we should be feeling. We should be sad in our hearts when we see that the young community of Muslims is straying away from the deen. So my dear brothers and sisters, I encourage you and I ask you, please do support this campaign and give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because my brothers and sisters, if you do not support this campaign, I don't think that we can do it. So we are depending upon your support. Brothers and sisters, please give for the sake of Allah and share the campaign. Use social media, use your Facebook, use your Twitter, use your Instagram, whatever kind of social media you have, use it. Please help us save the shabab of our country and help us spread the message of Islam to our society. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.